Coming up, as part of our series on Microsoft Teams for IT, I will show you the basics for configuring and managing Microsoft Teams. We'll take a look at the prerequisites for the best Microsoft Teams experience, planning for network capacity and deployment, Orgwise tenant-level controls that are available to you, as well as ways to customize Microsoft Teams for your organization. So let's start with the prerequisites. For the full Teams experience, as mentioned in part one of our series, every user should be enabled for Exchange Online, Microsoft Teams, and SharePoint Online. This is all performed as part of user management in the Microsoft 365 admin portal. Your users must also be enabled for Office 365 group creation to be able to create Teams. This is owned by default in your tenant, so if you have disabled it, you will want to turn it back on. To help you accelerate your onboarding, we created an advisor for Teams. This tool can be found in the Microsoft Teams Admin Center. Advisor for Teams not only surfaces these prerequisites, but also helps you plan a successful Teams deployment. You have the option of two workloads: chat, Teams, channels and apps, and meetings and conferencing. Advisor for Teams will run a series of assessments related to the selected workload. You can click VO to see the results. Here, you can see highlighted the areas that need your attention, in this case, related to Office 365 groups. Advisor for Teams also gives you a recommended plan and step-by-step guidance. By clicking View, you get guidance on how to best deploy the selected workload in your organization. Of course, a successful deployment will require a coordinated effort across different groups of stakeholders. An advisor for Teams allows you to bring your project team together. As part of the setup process, you will have the opportunity to add your deployment team. It's easy to add members at setup. Just click Add to find them and add them. In the dashboard, you can see the status of rollout by workload. Currently, in my first workload, I'm at 13% as we just started the work. And you can explore your status by selecting Open. This will launch Microsoft Teams and take you directly to the team that Advisor has automatically created for you, allowing you to collaborate in Teams as you plan and manage your deployment. You will see that a channel for chat, Teams, channels, and app has already been created. Additionally, we have a planner tab with all of the tasks needed to successfully roll out this workload to the organization. Here, you can assign tasks to members of your team and set deadlines. You will see a checklist of all of the activities related to these tasks, as well as resources to help you. In this case, we have links to our technical documentation for team settings and policies. Under the Forms tab, we give you a user satisfaction survey to help you collect end-user feedback specific to the workload that you're deploying. Now, for the meeting and conferencing workload, you will see a step called Assess Your Network Per Site. If this is not applicable to your rollout, you can skip it. But if you're a distributed organization or new to cloud and running your unified communications on-prem, the network planning tool can help you determine the impact of Microsoft Teams on your internet bandwidth. You can get to it from the Teams Admin Center. I have already set up a plan with my sites, and as you can see here, it has calculated my network requirements for deploying Teams and Cloud Voice across my organization's physical locations. Lastly, while Teams offers a great experience for modern browsers, we recommend you to deploy the Teams app to your user devices. Microsoft Teams configuration deployment is now part of Office 365 Pro Plus, which greatly streamlines the process of deploying the Teams app. In the Office customization tool at config.office.com, here's where you would configure Teams as part of your install. This integrates your existing deployment tools such as Config Manager and Microsoft Intune, and you can learn more at aka.ms/Office IT Series. So now that we have covered the prerequisites for both planning and rolling out Teams, let's take a look at the controls that you have to craft the Teams experience for your users. In Microsoft Teams, we have two broad categories in terms of admin controls: settings, which apply to everyone in the organization, and policies that allow you to tailor Teams to the needs of specific groups of users. Let's take a look at some of the most common controls you have to manage Microsoft Teams. Under Orgwise settings, you can manage things like external access, where you can allow or block domains from connecting to your organization via Teams. Guest access, to enable people outside your organization to access Teams and channels with only the need for an email address. Here, you can define what calling, meetings, and messaging features are available to guests. Teams settings, which allow you to manage features such as notifications and feeds, email integration, and files. For example, you can turn off third-party file sharing and cloud file storage options for the Files tab. Under Teams Upgrade, you are presented with 5 options to upgrade to Teams if you're coming from Skype for Business, which we will cover later in this series. Next, let's take a look at some of the policies available to customize the Teams experience for your users. Policies can be applied at the user or group level. Under Messaging Policies, you can select which chat and channel messaging features are available to users in Microsoft Teams. For example, you can define whether users are able to edit or delete messages. You can also manage the use of GIFs, memes, and stickers. Also, you can enable message translation from here, and turn on accessibility features or priority notifications. You can also set meeting policies. Here, you can control the features that are available to meeting participants for meetings that are scheduled by users in your organization, with controls for audio, video, content sharing, participants, and even guests. For example, you can enable meeting transcription and cloud recording. Of course, as you customize Teams for your organization, you want to think about the apps that are available and accessible via Teams. Microsoft Teams brings together all of your organization's apps into a single place to help your users stay productive, and we have the controls to help you manage Teams apps. With app permission policies, you can control what apps are available to Microsoft Teams users. You can allow or block apps published by Microsoft, third parties, or your organization. When you block an app, users are unable to install it from the Teams App Store. As you determine which apps you want to make available in Teams, you can also take advantage of the new app catalog, which can help you get the information you need to confidently enable apps from the Microsoft Teams Admin Center. The catalog shows you details such as name, certification status, publisher, and the status of the apps available in your Teams tenant. By clicking in the certification status, you can see more information to help you make an informed decision. In the General tab, you can see publisher information. On the Data Handling, you can see how this application manages your information. And the Security and Compliance sections show you detailed security information as well as compliance details such as supported regulations and standards. Once you have created your policies, you can apply them to specific users. So for example, Adele here is configured for all of our global default policies with the exception of her messaging policy, which is set up to a manager policy. And of course, you can use PowerShell to assign policies to a large group of users, using commandlets available in the Microsoft Teams PowerShell module. So, we covered the prerequisites for the best Microsoft Teams experience, planning for network capacity and deployment, and some of the core ways to personalize Microsoft Teams for your organization. Keep checking back on their Microsoft Teams for IT series. Next up, we'll cover the basics on security and compliance. And of course, for more guidance, including a complete list of the Microsoft Teams settings and policies, check out aka.ms/successwithteams. Thanks for watching!